In this video, we will look at the Boolean operators and understand how they work. And then we will look at how you can use them in OneSearch and in an example database. So let's start by understanding what Boolean operators are. Boolean operators allow you to make your search more complicated and therefore more specific to what you need to get back. So one of the first Boolean operators that's important to know is AND. When you connect two words with AND, the search results will all be items featuring both search terms. So as seen in this Venn diagram, if I ran a search cats and dogs, I would only get results that talked about both cats and dogs. I wouldn't get any results that talked about cats without talking about dogs, and I wouldn't get any results that talked about dogs without talking about cats. It is useful to note that for many basic search terms, an AND is assumed between the words that you type, but if you want to be sure, or if you're running a more advanced search or in a search tool that you know does not do that, you can type AND and you will find the results will be only items that feature both of the search terms, the one in front of and behind the AND. Next up is OR. If you type OR in between two search terms, the search results will be items that feature either of the search terms or both of the search terms. So basically, it's going to be everything in this Venn diagram. Items that talk about cats, items that talk about dogs, and items that talk about both. This will be broader than what you get if you run an AND search with the same terms, for example. The third Boolean operator to know is NOT. If you run a search with the word not between two words, the search results will not include the items that feature the term or terms preceded by the word not. So in this case, if I wrote cats, not dogs, not precedes the words dogs, which means that I will not get any results that mention dogs. I will only get results that mention cats, as seen in the Venn diagram. This then narrows our results compared to having an OR. Now let's look at how Boolean searching works in the library's catalog called OneSearch. From the library's homepage, you can scroll down to find the OneSearch search bar. Let's start with our search with an AND. Running this search, you'll see that we get 417,413 results. And taking a look at them, you can see that this very first one mentions both dog and cat. And down here as well, cat and dog. So it's clear that this is returning materials that talk about both. Now, what would happen if we change this word to an OR? Well, we would expect that this would probably be more materials, and that now we would get materials that talked about just cats, and materials that talked about just dogs, as well as materials that talked about both. So let's run the search again, and you'll see that I do in fact get far more materials, over 4 million, and you'll see that they do talk about cats, dog. This is canine, so that's also related to dogs. So it's not showing words as much that where both are covered, and it is showing far more results. Now, let's say I change this instead to not. What if I wanted only materials about cats and not dogs? We would expect this to be fewer than the OR, and we would expect not to see anything with dogs. So let's run that search and see. So you can see that now I got 1.5 million, a little more than, and everything here says cat. No mention of dogs that we see. So let's say that you wanted to do a more complicated search even than that one Boolean. Using the advanced search can help guide you through using multiple Booleans. So using this, I could say cats here, and then I could say, let's say I want to use an OR, so I want anything that talks about cats or dogs. And then I can even add a new line and say, well, let's say not. Maybe I don't want anything that talks about horses. So this is going to give me anything that talks about cats or talks about dogs or both, but nothing that mentions horses at all. And you'll see that this advanced search allows me to do other things as well. I could also find different types of materials. I could sort by language, or I could pick a specific date range. But let's stick with the Boolean for now and see what happens. And if I click, you'll see my results are down here at the bottom, and it is actually fewer results than what I received when I ran a simple OR search, because it's eliminated all of the results that mention horses. In other academic databases, Boolean searches work in a similar manner. For example, using Academic Search Complete, one of our databases, you can see that if you click on Advanced Search, you'll be taken to a form that does offer you the option to use Booleans. So we could construct the same sort of search that we did in one search, again using Booleans. So I could say cats, and then change this to an or, and then I could also say dogs, and then not horses. And if I run this search, you'll see that it's going to bring up items that have cats or dogs, or both, and we won't find any mentions of horses. Now you will see that it's bringing back as the top results items that have both cats and dogs. And that has to do with relevancy, not the Boolean search itself. So that demonstrates how Boolean searches work in both databases and OneSearch. They can be very useful in constructing more useful and efficient searches. If you have questions on this or anything else, please ask the library.